So now let's begin with the point development. So we all know that as we grow, our height and weight increases. And with the age, our physical strength also increases. That means we are able to do various tasks. When a baby is born, he is just able to move his hand, legs, yes? But as the time passes, he is able to lift certain things. Yeah? As he grows, he is able to pick up ball, throw the ball, then he is able to lift the bag, yes? So the strength, from this we understand that the physical strength is going on increasing, yes? And at the same time, we keep learning new skills. In this way, every individual makes progress. This is called development. The next thing that is observe on page number 116. Try to observe a cow or a cat to find out all that she does for her young ones. And also all the things that the calf and the kitten learn to do on their own. So, the cow or the cat takes care, protects and nurtures its young ones. They communicate with their young ones and guide them about what to eat and where to go. Similarly, the young ones of animals also learn skill like obtaining their own food, protecting themselves from sun and rain and from their enemy. When young ones of animals grow up, they begin to live independently. We learn some skills to live independently, and also do animals learn some skill. The difference between two is that animals learn only a certain number of skills in their life. Animals have to learn only skills like obtaining their own food, protecting themselves. Compared to that, man has to learn a lot to live independently. Human beings have go on learning many more things throughout their life. So the next thing that is find out. How many years does it take the young ones of the tiger or elephant to start living independently? So the children, the young one of tiger needs around 1.5 years to live independently. While the young ones of elephant require 5 to 10 years to live independently. Next, we have compare on page number 117. Can you play football, lagori 7 tiles, cook a meal, press clothes, shop for provisions, nurse a person who is ill? Write a summary. Means you have, these are some points like playing football, lagori, cooking a meal, okay? So these are some of the tasks or skills. So you have to write a summary on this, whether you are able to do these things, yes? Next, they are telling us that we are allowed to drive a motor vehicle, vote in an election only after a certain age. Use your brain power. Many skills have been mentioned in this lesson up to now. Can you do without learning some of them? Means which skills are not compulsory? Next question, which ones are necessary for any person? So, unlike animals, man does not need the skill of obtaining his own food. But it is necessary for him to have the knowledge of cooking food. Also, man need not have the skill to protect himself from weather or from enemy. But it is necessary for man to have proper knowledge and skills to fulfill his needs of clothes and shelter for his own protection. In the same way, education is necessary to gain knowledge. It is also necessary for man to have the skill to earn money for his livelihood. In short, man has to learn skills required for fulfilling his basic needs, that is, food, clothing, and shelter. and skills required for living. So up till now we have studied about many skills which you are able to see on the screen and which have been mentioned in this lesson. It is not necessary that we should acquire all this skill. It doesn't even matter if we don't even know skills like skipping, cycling, playing football, swimming, climbing a tree, playing lagori. But it also doesn't matter if at present if you do not know tasks like cooking and ironing the cloth. But as you grow older, you should know these two tasks. Think about it on page number 117. Question 1. Which are some of the tasks you like to do? Which ones you would like to do in future? So the first, I'm going to tell you the answer of both the question. It is writing an essay or writing a summary. Next, combing hair, cooking food, by hearting a poem or learning a poem, storytelling, giving a speech, counting money, tidying the place, writing a letter, sending an email, playing outdoor games, purchasing, shopping for provision, nursing a patient who is ill. So here I have given you some examples of some of the tasks which you would like to do or which you would like to do in future. So the answer will be of personal response, so you can write the answer on your own in the textbook with pencil. Question 2. What things would you like to do just for recreation? Recreation means for refreshment, okay? So which task you would like to do? So here are the picture of some of the tasks. Can you recognize? Yes, for recreation, we can do tasks such as cooking, painting, singing or stitching. So these are some examples which I gave you for recreation. You may also have some other example. It depends on you. Whatever you like to do, you can do that things for recreation. Question 3. What would you like to do daily when you grow up? So if you are fond of art of drawing or painting, then you can become an artist. If you are fond of singing, then you can become an excellent singer. If you like to cook food, then you can have an hotel of your own. As we all know, we acquire some early skills like walking and running as per our age without having to be taught. But there are some skills which we learn later as we grow. These many skills have to be taught to us. We learn many skills from our parents, teachers, and other adults. The greater the number of skills we learn, less is our dependence on others. Means when we learn more number of skills, then we don't have to depend on others for our work. It never happens that we do all our tasks by ourselves. We have to depend on some other people to get our task completed. For example, not all people stitch their own clothes. Means if we want our clothes to be stitched, then we have to depend on, yes, we have to depend on the tailors, yes, because we are unable to do that task of stitching, yes. So here we are dependent on tailor to get our clothes stitched. Next, nor does everyone grow their own food. You can see it in the second picture. Here we have to depend on our farmers to get the food. Yes, because we are not able to cultivate our own food. Afterwards, we are able to cook. But the grains what we get, we have to depend for grains on the farmers only, isn't it? So there are some tasks which we are unable to do, but which we can get it done. Yeah. So we must all learn to take the responsibility for doing our personal task ourselves. Instead of depending on others, we should take our own responsibility that we should do our personal work ourselves. So now let's learn more about the skill. So here is the story of Siley. Siley is in the 6th standard. They are going on a picnic. Siley's Aayi is going to make laddus for the whole class, but she needs Siley's help. What can Siley do to help her? Yes, Siley can make a list of the things required to make a laddu. She can also take money from her mother to buy those things. Next help what she can do is that she can pack the laddus in the box. So which of her skills will she use to help her mother? Yes. So the skills which she can use to help her mother are, she can make the list properly according to the ingredients and the quantity. Then she can go to the shop and buy those things according to the list in correct quantity. Then she should have the skill of paying money, counting the money and getting it back. Next skill of packing the laddus in the box and taking care that no laddus will be damaged later on while after packing. So now let's begin with the new point, that is heredity. How tall does one grow? Yes, a person can grow in height till he or she is about 18 years old. Think of people you know who are 18 or older. Of these people, how many are very much taller or shorter than their parents? So here on the screen you can see a family picture. Here if you will see, then the children are totally resembling their parents. But there are some children in some of the families, which you can see in the second picture, they are much taller or much shorter than their parents. Okay, so children, our looks means how we look, our build means the way we are, and other physical characteristics are like our parents. Yes, so it is said that people from one family look similar. Yes, means there are many similarities in us and in our family members. Okay, so some of our features or traits means how we look, how we talk, the behavior, even our hair color, the way we are behaving. Yes, these are called as the features. Okay, so the features or traits are of us are like those are grandparents, our parent siblings means like our uncles and aunties. Okay, so sometimes what happens, the people who are recognizing our family members and they do not recognize us, but looking at us they come to know who we are. This is because we are having some features like our family members. Did you understand? So being born with certain features or traits in common with the members of our family is called heredity. Okay, so having similarities with our family, that features or traits are called as heredity. So there are many inherited traits. Inherited means which we receive by genetic transmission. Okay, so there are many traits in us which are like our family members, but no one is having any control which traits we will inherit from them or which we are not going to inherit. Means from whom what we are going to get, that we don't know and even others don't know. Now when a baby is born, like whom will that baby look like, a mother or like father, like or by like someone else, we don't know that. Yes, but there are features in that baby, and later on as he or she grows, he will look like that particular family member. So there are many inherited features in us, but no one is having any control over that, which will inherit and which we will not inherit. Okay.